1,000 Americans have signed up to sponsor Ukrainian refugees, according to recent data from the Department of Homeland Security. And one person who was quietly tapped by U.S. officials for how to do this effectively was Lionel Rosenblatt.
Yeah, he and a team helped craft what later became known as the Refugee Act of 1980. Rosenblatt was in Minnesota recently and sat down with us to talk about the creative ways that they were able to get Southeast Asians, particularly the Hmong, to the United States.
Boxes.
So this is all of his stuff.
With one name, Rosenblatt.
I was refugee coordinator based at the U.S. Embassy in Bangkok.
Lionel Rosenblatt was a Foreign Service officer in the 70s when the U.S. allocated 150,000 Vietnamese to resettle here after the fall of Saigon. Some remain unused, so Lionel went to find those left behind.
I made the case to the bureaucracy, actually to Henry Kissinger, that we ought to use the remaining 11,000 on refugees who had come out to Thailand from Laos and Cambodia. You see, I was armed with an SO road map and an embassy driver and put a tie on him. We bought a couple of cases of scotch and talked our way out to the various border camps and did a complete interview of everybody that had come in.
On his last day, he ended up in Udorn, Thailand, and learned about the Hmong, who had been closely integrated with U.S. forces under the CIA during the Secret War and credited with saving American lives. But they weren't part of the resettlement stream.
It was a mystery to me why they were good enough to fight for us but not good enough to consider for resettlement. We just knew that there was a bias against resettlement for the Hmong.
That meant they didn't use the word Highlanders in documents as Hmong were referred to.
And that's how we kind of disguised our early moves.
Lists were made, and in total, 5,500 initially came from Laos.
And here's the original list with Chen Wang Pao's signature.
Li Paozhong is the director at the Center for Hmong Studies at Concordia University.
It helps us reconnect the dots. We are here. How did we get here? And how do we end up here?
Some of those answers.
Without Lionel, we wouldn't be here.
Are in Rosenblatt's boxes.
Well, the point is that given opportunity, this country still is amazing in the way it can bring out human potential from people around the world. And it's an inspiring example for us as well as for other countries to see. And we ought to continue to do that. We need that kind of fresh blood and energy in this country.
And an interesting tidbit that Lionel actually shared with Gia was that the Hmong were the only group that he encountered who wanted to all stay together, and clan leaders came up with a lot of different options, so the U.S. couldn't make it happen in its capacity. Only when Lionel told them about secondary migration in the United States did they agree to come here.
Interesting. Yeah. All right, well, Jen, you have...